Hi, I'm Brentley, a developer evangelist at BuildBuddy, and today I'm going to tell you about a rule set that many awesome contributors and I have created called rulesxcodeproj. So to understand what rulesxcodeproj is and why it was created, I have to make sure you know what Xcode is and how it works. Xcode is Apple's IDE. It's the primary IDE used to develop for their platforms, such as iOS and macOS. Most Apple platform developers prefer or are required to use Xcode. Xcode has its own build system, commonly referred to as Xcode build. And it doesn't natively support using other build systems, such as Bazel. And finally, Xcode uses an Xcode proj file to describe a project. This single, sometimes massive, XML file can be unruly for large teams to manage. So many of them generate their project from declarative sources of truth, such as YAML files, that end up behaving a lot like Bazel's build files. Now enter rulesxcodeproj. Rulesxcodeproj is a simple, powerful, and fully featured Bazel-integrated Xcode project generator. It's simple because everything is defined in build files, the same as the rest of your workspace, using easy-to-understand constructs. It's powerful because it seamlessly supports Bazel's code gen, multi-language, and remote capabilities. And it's fully featured because it supports all of Xcode's native features, such as indexing, integrated testing, and SwiftUI previews. There's only a few steps needed to get up and running with rulesxcodeproj. First, in your workspace file, you need to add a dependency on rulesxcodeproj. Then you need to load its dependencies. And it's dependencies. So don't worry. The release notes on GitHub provide an easy-to-copy snippet so you don't have to figure this out yourself. And later this year, hopefully, we have Bazel mode support as well. Next, in a build file, you need to define an Xcode proj target that includes all the top-level targets you want in your project. Transitive dependencies will be included automatically. And finally, you need to invoke Bazel run on that Xcode proj target to generate the project. And now you can open the generated project and immediately start editing, running, and testing your targets. Let's open up a generated project and see how it behaves. The first thing you might notice when opening your project is that Xcode is indexing it. This is because rulesxcodeproj supports Xcode's live indexing. Xcode's indexing powers a range of functionality, including syntax highlighting, refactoring, and jump to definition. SwiftUI previews are fully supported with rulesxcodeproj. Here I have a preview that's part of a framework target. When I resume the preview, it builds and displays. If I replace part of this string with a new value, then the preview updates as expected. Debugging with LLDB is also fully supported. To show this off, I've set some breakpoints. Of note, I've set them in both workspace and generated files. Let's run the tests to hit some of these breakpoints. There are two tests. One has the app as a test host, while the other doesn't. The first breakpoint we hit is in the app. This file is generated by Bazel and resides in Bazel-out. We're able to print out the self variable and the internal value variable. The next breakpoint we hit is in an Objective-C file. This file is doing something special, though, as you can see when I step into this function here. This value is coming from REST. Rulesxcodeproj supports debugging multi-language projects. And the final breakpoint we hit is in the app tests. And we're able to print out the internal value variable that is defined in the app. Now we can continue to let the other tests run. This is a breakpoint I didn't set explicitly. We've hit the runtime issue breakpoint. This appeared because rulesxcodeproj supports the use of the runtime sanitizers, which can be enabled in schemes. I previously enabled the thread sanitizer for the scheme. Also, navigating from the runtime issue works as expected. The current scheme is set to run both of our tests, but Xcode supports running a subset of tests. Here, I'm going to change the tech variable, which would cause both the tests to fail. But I'm only going to rerun one of the tests to show that Xcode's test selection works. So the test failure will show up in the issue navigator. And clicking it navigates to the fail and assert. This is noteworthy since Bazel compiles with relative paths and rules Xcode-proj has to accommodate for to have Xcode navigate properly. The final thing I want to demo today is a capability of rules Xcode-proj called focus targets. By selecting certain targets to focus or unfocus, you can change which targets appear in the generated project. Normally, Xcode needs all transitive targets represented in the project. But since we leverage Bazel as our build system, we're able to exclude targets if we want. In this example, I'm focused on the app target. So even though we still list the test targets in the Xcode project declaration, they and their transitive library targets won't appear in the focus project. Over in the project navigator, only the files for the app target are included. And when I run the scheme, everything will build correctly, and the app launches. So thank you for letting me show you how to use Rules Xcode-proj to integrate Bazel with Xcode. It can be found at this link on GitHub. And the workspace I used for the demo is also on GitHub at this link. Thank you again.